Recommendations to be considered during storage and transport of bagged grain. Grain to be stored should be cleaned. When using a manual thresher, it is recommended to place a clean tarp on the floor to avoid the contact of grain with soil or dust particles. A careful removal of foreign material needs to be done before bagging.
Use a cup to capture a sample of grain. This can be used to determine the moisture level of your grain. This will help keep your grain safe.
Bags that are used for the transport and storage of grain must also be clean, with no holes. Once full, bags must be perfectly closed by sewing. During transportation, it is necessary to protect the load. The truck box must be clean. Holes or cracks in the floor or on the rails should be repaired. Sharp or cutting surfaces that could puncture the bags as a result of movements and vibrations during the trip must be removed. Loads must be protected by covers or tarps that will prevent them from getting wet during rain. Any cracks and holes on the tarp should be repaired. This cover will also protect the grain from being attacked or contaminated by the action of birds or simply from falling off the moving vehicle. One must install strips made of metal, wood, or bamboo on top of the box so that the tarp forms a cover that avoids the accumulation of water, which may eventually leak into the load. Covers must extend from the top of the load and cover one-third of the side of the truck box. The cover should be tied tightly to the grips on the rails with ties or straps. During the trip, one must make regular stops to check the status of the cargo and the tarp, and if necessary, rearrange the load and adjust the moorings of the tarp. The sacks or bags should be stowed indoors in a clean, well-ventilated, and closed premise. When using smaller storage outbuildings, which are usually located on farms, make sure that these are elevated from the floor area. A useful, easy-to-apply device to avoid rodent infestation is the placement of metal or plastic strips on the legs of the structure. Each season, make sure that the roof will withstand rain and wind so that stored bags will remain dry at all times. The walls also need to provide protection against water and some sort of secure closure to keep the grain safe. On larger storage buildings, it is important to conduct seasonal inspections and repairs of roof and walls. This will prevent any moisture from getting inside the building. Install metal screens on ventilation orifices that allow air to circulate freely, but keep insects and rodents away. The entrance door should also provide a solid and secure closure. Inside the storage building, bags must be protected from the attack of rodents that may enter. Bait stations can be placed around the building, trying to place them close to the walls and corners. A clay, metal, or wood device with small openings can be used to keep the bait protected inside and avoid accidental intake by domestic pets or little children. Grain bags must be stored over pallets or platforms, away from the moisture of the floor, and to allow air to circulate freely under the stored bags. These raised platforms can be made of wood, brick, tree branches, or metal. It is very important to consider the shape and arrangement in which grain bags are stored. Bags must be placed in a way that they will lock one to the other, and by doing so, the entire stack will be more stable and secure. The technique will be different if you use individual pallets or larger platforms, as shown in the animation. If individual pallets are used, it is recommended to stock no more than 8 layers in height. For larger platforms, the height could be more, when a stable configuration through the locking of bags in each layer was maintained. Make sure to leave enough room of separation between the stacks of bags and the outer walls. Also, enough room must be kept between the stacks to allow for an easy access. They should be built so that they will be relatively easy to inspect and determine the conservation condition of bags and grain, which is difficult if the piles are very large and compact. If there are problems, such as rodent, insect attacks, or bacteria and fungi activity, continuous and frequent inspections will allow us to apply corrective measures immediately after the problem has been detected. Under high humidity and high temperature during storage, it will be required to conduct periodic rotations of the bags so that they can be aired out. Early detection of problems will permit to apply corrective measures immediately as they appear.